Hello, I'm Dr. Johnson Steigelman, the lead instructor for most physics courses here at Finger Lakes Community College. What I'd like to do is take a moment to let you know a little bit about HonorLock, which is the proctoring service that we use here to make sure that you're the person who's actually taking your exam. So if you go to your course, I'm going to go into my master course where I'm collecting this. You will notice on the left-hand side, there should be a menu. If you're not seeing that menu, click on it to get it to show up and go ahead into course content. Here under the icebreaker activities, I have set up a quiz that will get you familiar with using HonorLock and this folder that's called appropriately using HonorLock. So you're going to click on that. And right now I have the HonorLock extension in Chrome. I'm going to remove that for a second so that you can see how easy it is to put in. Okay, you are not going to see this piece here that's called HonorLock. The reason that you won't see that is because this is where I go in and check out what's going on with HonorLock and where I set my settings and so on. So here under the HonorLock dry run, this is the actual quiz. Now during the regular semester, you're not going to use HonorLock for quizzes. You're only going to use it for exams. But I have this low stakes quiz going on here for you. And I'm going to walk you the whole way through the quiz. So I'm going to click on that. And notice that it is asking me to put the extension in. Now I have to agree to this. So I'm going to click that. I've read the terms and the privacy policy for this. Now I'm going to click get started. It's going to take me to a new window. This is the Chrome Web Store. All I need to do is click add to Chrome, add the extension. Okay, and I get rid of that screen. If you leave this guy on, then you won't have to do this for the rest of the semester. If you have privacy concerns, which I am completely understanding of, I wish I didn't have to do this, but in order for other universities to accept our credits, they often ask, are you using some type of a proctoring service? And we have found this one to be one of the more reasonable ones that's available. Okay, so we are going to go ahead and take this quiz. Notice it says HonorLock is enabled. And I'm going to hit begin. Okay, and it's going to give me this link to launch proctoring. I'm going to click that. And now I have to go through a couple of steps. The first one is I need to get my picture taken. And you can see up here in this screen, this is exactly what you will see. Now, what I want you to be aware of is HonorLock is going to record you taking the exam. So you need to wear something that is reasonable to wear where somebody else might see you. I probably wouldn't wear this getup to take my exam, but I don't have to get perfectly dressed up. And I just wanted you to see, I got up this morning, I didn't wash my hair, didn't put on my bow tie, didn't do any of those things that I might normally do if I was actually going into the classroom. But the first thing I need to do here, once I feel comfortable, wear some pants, wear a shirt. You can wear your pajamas if you'd like. Just make sure that you've got something on tops and bottoms. Okay, so you're just going to get your face in here. You're going to take the photo. Very easy to do. If your face isn't quite in the right spot, it will ask you to do it again. And then you're going to use your ID. I'd recommend that you use your school ID to do this. I don't need to see your driver's license or your social security card or anything else like that. You're going to click on this. And now you can see here that you need to hold this up. And you actually need to do this two-handed because you need to actually take the photo of this. You need to hold it steady. You need to get it in there close enough. And you need to let your camera focus. Okay. The first time I did this, it took five times. So I'm going to try again. Okay, once again, it didn't quite pick up. Maybe get it just a little bit closer. Okay, so it might take a couple of times to do that. So the next thing you need to be aware of is it is going to ask you to look around the room. I'm in my office. I probably wouldn't take exams in my office. I would go down to my dining room, or maybe I'd clean up my office before I did this, because there's a lot of stuff going on in this room. And I'll let you see what's going on, since you're allowing me to come into your house. Okay, there's my door. If you have a door in the room, it's probably better to close that. And you can spin around. And also make sure that you look at your work area. This is why wearing pants is kind of important. Now, my desk is a little messy. I should really clear this off. There are a few things that I can have at my desk, but I might get dinged because of all this that's going on here. Okay, now notice I didn't actually hit begin the room scan. So I'm going to do this again. And this will actually help my wire not get overdone. So I'm going to just spin around, make sure that the door's closed. Go the rest of the way around. If you have a laptop, you'll have to pick your laptop up to do this. Okay, take a look down at your work area. And then get your camera back in place. Sit back down. And while I'm still here on the camera, again, realize that somebody might look at this. I will generally not look at it, and I'll show you the conditions under which I would look at it. You might actually have somebody come in using the chat window down here and let you know that something is out of line. So for example, if you're listening to the radio or somebody in the house is watching TV and there's a voice off in the distance, the artificial intelligence that's monitoring everybody is going to say, I hear something that might be somebody cheating. I'm going to call in a live proctor. The live proctor will come in, ask what's going on. And 9 times out of 10, they're going to say, okay, just make sure you turn the radio off and continue on. If another person comes in the room and walks behind you, that's going to trigger that. So isolating yourself somewhere is the way to go. Again, you don't have to get all dressed up for this. You don't have to put on makeup or take makeup off. Just be somewhat presentable, because real people might actually see you during this. We're not going to watch it the whole time, but you might get flagged that somebody's going to come in and take a look. Now, once you've shown that, go ahead and hit I'm done. And it's going to run through this. So we get to see the video again. I'm not going to sit through the whole thing. You probably should. And now I'm ready to launch my screen recording. Okay, you can only have one screen up. If you have multiple screens, it's going to give you a window that says that's a problem. So if you need to change your display settings on a Windows computer, go ahead in here. Notice that I do have multiple monitors, but these two, number two, is disconnected. I haven't physically disconnected it. Just right now, nothing's being sent to it. Same way with screen three, whereas screen one is my main display. Okay, it won't let you go any further if you have multiple screens. So I'm going to click that. That's the one I want to share. And I'm pretty much now ready to go. So just to let you see, and you may have noticed this earlier. So here's a mirror. I use this side. Okay. Well, that's really not showing what I want it to show. Okay, there's a monitor to the side. The monitor is turned off. There's my main monitor. And there's my third monitor turned off. There's my window. Okay, so you need to turn those off. You don't have to remove them from the room. You don't have to disconnect them. You just need to electronically disconnect them from there. So now I'm ready to begin. Okay, notice this is going live. This is the proctoring session that is in progress. I'm going to keep this up so you can see me talking. Okay, so we've got our setup here. If you would like to get rid of this, go ahead and click on the side. It gives you a little bit more room. There are four questions on this exam. And first question is, when do we use HonorLock? And the answer to this is only during module exams and the final exam. Even though this is a quiz that we're doing right now, it's the only quiz that you have to do it for. You don't have to do it for homework. You don't have to do it for every assignment, only during the module exams and the final exam. Okay, once you click this, a moment later, this will say saved, and then it will move on to the next question. You just click the link here. Okay, what do you need to use HonorLock? Well, you need to have a relatively isolated, quiet room. You don't want to take this in the middle of a cafeteria somewhere. Not that you can get out if you're still under isolation. You do need your student ID, and you do need to have a webcam. The webcam on your laptop is perfectly fine for it. You probably will have a different angle here because your screen, your camera is going to point up. Make sure at least your head, your face is in there. It might take a little bit of maneuvering for it. So we do need all of those. Okay, notice after a moment that clicks saved. Go on to the next one. Okay, websites that you can use during the time you're taking the exam. I've got a couple up here. So one of the ones that you can use is obviously Blackboard. If you couldn't get into Blackboard, you could be in trouble. Now, the thing to notice about this is that I can get into my course. I could even get into other courses during this. And you can actually get to your notes in here. So let's see, course information. Actually, I want course content. I could go in here and open up one of these links and download it. Now, of course, this process takes time. So you might want to have any notes up and ready to go. Of course, the more windows you have going, the more difficult it might be. There's my notes, so I could go back and take a look at them. I would recommend that you have notes set up and ready to go. You've gone through these, you've written some things down, condensed it down to a lot smaller set of stuff in there. Okay, you can use Wikipedia. I don't have Wikipedia up here. So if I go Wikipedia, org, it's going to let me get into that, and then I could look things up here. Again, Wikipedia is a great resource. However, if you're looking for everything in Wikipedia, you're not going to get the exam done. You can also use Desmos.com Scientific. This is a scientific calculator, and you see I have one set up here where I've got all my numbers set up. I've done all my algebra. This is the last step. All I need to do is put my numbers in, and I get my answer. Whenever you transfer the answer over, make sure you use proper significant digits. Make sure you use the proper units. But you can get to this. If you have a regular calculator, you can use that. You cannot use the calculator on your phone. So we can use any of these, no others. So let me show you what happens if you try to go to twitter.com to share answers. Notice it got rid of that window. Facebook, it got rid of that as well. Okay, so you can only use these classes, or excuse me, these websites right here during the class. So any of these and no others. Okay, and during the exam, you can have a few sheets of scratch paper. You can have a notebook down here. Again, I've probably got a little bit too much here on my desk. It's okay to have your student ID there. The rest of this junk I should probably get out of here. If you have the textbook and you bought the full version of it, you can go ahead and use it. I have not bought a hard copy of the textbook. I just use the browser window with the website actually on it. Okay, same way with the calculator. You can either use a regular calculator or Desmos. And any of those above, not much else. I'm going to hit save my answer. And then I finally need to hit save and submit. This will come up to say, make sure you want to stay in. Please read these pop-ups that come up so that you don't accidentally leave in the middle of an exam. So I'm going to hit OK. Okay, now I've submitted this. The HonorLock has shut down. I'm going to hit OK. And here are my results.